Hey guys, so we got a new Team of the Week. Again, Team of the Week's being chosen currently via The Sims and, you know, community input. So let's go over who the Team of the Week was for April 1st. And we'll start with the 89, Tyler Bertuzzi. Again, these guys are going to be ones that aren't really usable at the end game or ones that, you know, if you're trying to compete for the GWC, probably not really going to help you all that much. But we got the 89, Tyler Bertuzzi. Well, he's getting up there in speed, which isn't bad at all. Going to be a cheap one. I would sell immediately, though, if I did pack him. Then we've got the 88, Adam Henrique. Same kind of thing. He does have 2 to X, so he would get bumped up in speed. Shots in the high 80s, and his faceoff's 92, so he is usable in terms of having a depth centerman. Then we've got the 91, Ilya Kovalchuk. This card is still very usable. 6'3", 225, and, you know, decent speed in the mid-90s, but his shot is also in the mid-90s. Hand stats all above 90 as well, and his size alone makes him useful. He'd be a good fourth-line right-handed winger card for you, regardless of how good your team is, if you are looking to upgrade in the bottom pairing for, you know, an endgame team or anyone that's still competing in the GWC. After that, we've got the 96 Steven Stamkos, an endgame offensive card, as he's got basically max skating and close to max shooting, as well as hand stats that are almost touching 99 as well, offensive and defensive awareness at 98. You really wouldn't need another Steven Stamkos if you know, he does get his 98 or 99 eventually. This would do just the trick. And with 96 faceoffs, you can put him at the center. I would put him on wing, though. Just again, I'm not really good, and I don't like right-handed centermen. This card is very, very good, and you couldn't go wrong if you were able to get him for your wings. And we've got the 87 Brandon Gallagher, not really usable at all, no matter the rating, just 5'9", not really usable in the meta. And we've got the 88 Tom Wilson. He's too slow. His size is great, but I mean, there's still a 90 overall master set Tom Wilson if you really wanted him. Then for depth, we've got Adrian Kempe. Same kind of thing, just too small. Does have good size though. If you're a free to play team and you're still looking for an upgrade from base cards, wouldn't be a bad option. Jonathan Marchessault, the 95 overall. Unfortunately, again, he's, you know, great ratings in terms of skating, shot, all that kind of stuff, but at 5'9", you're just going to lose the puck if you come anywhere near anyone that's large in this game. So unless you straight line down the boards, there's far better options than him. I would sell him for whatever the, you know, the market value is on him. Got the 91 Kyle Palmieri, not a bad card, just under 6 foot, but does have decent speed and shot over 90. Again, he'd be a decent right-handed winger card option if someone's, you know, looking to upgrade the fourth line kind of thing. Jesper Bratt, you can avoid this one, 85 overall and only 5'10, far better options. Oscar Moeller, 83 overall, 5'10, same kind of thing. Not really much you can do with this. The 83 Dominik Zwerger. Even free-to-play players, there's base cards that are better than him, so, again, sell if you were to pack him. And then on to defense, we got the 90 overall, Shea Theodore, 6'2", so decent size and good speed at over 97 skating, essentially across the board. Then his shot over 90 for the power on slap shot, which isn't bad at all, passing puck control at 89, body checking at 87. And then his offensive awareness stats at shot blocking, stick checking, just under 90 as well. Not a bad cheap left defenseman option. I still think there's far better, but you probably get him very cheap in terms of market value. After him, we got the 97 Chris Letang. End game card, essentially, at this point, is a right-handed defenseman. 99 skating across the board, 97 shot power with 88 accuracies, passing puck control, and body checking all above 90. His awareness stats are fantastic. This is a great right defenseman card to have, and you don't need an upgrade over him. And we've got the 88 Zdeno Chara. Enough of the Charas. I mean, if you cannot get the 93 version, even with 90 skating, he still has a place because you can deny zone entries and whatnot. There's nothing people can do about him. He's just so large and one of the most overpowering cards in the game still. So I'm curious to see what his price is, but it's, you know, he's not a bad card, even though his speed is brutal. 83, Brett Pesce, nice size, but skating a 90, it's not enough size to, like, Zdeno Chara to make up for it. Dmitry Samarkov, I butchered that. Yeah, you can avoid here. I mean, he does have good size, and his skating is around 95, but that shot accuracy is in the low 70s. Yeah, pass. Stefan Espeland, again, just sell if you get him. And then in net, we've got the 91 Braden Holtby. He's got okay size with that aggression. It's at 84. Hard pass for me. I did just release a video that showed the top five goaltenders, in my opinion, based on stats and builds. I would go with anyone over that by far. And then backing up him, we've got Michael Gertig. I probably said that wrong as well. This is a terrible build. 6'1", 80 glove high, 81 positioning and aggression over 80. Yeah, hard pass here. We also got a few prime times in the 95 Tyson Barry. Very, very good card. Again, a right defense. I mean, he's small at 5'10". Much rather have the Letang. But if you were able to pack him, not terrible to keep regardless of who else you have. Unless you've got, like, let's say, you know, Tyler Myers or the Carlson, that kind of thing. I also need to mention, guys, the Team of the Year cards have gone up by +1. A Team of the Season as well. As we've got the Alex Ovechkin here, I've got him at 99 now, so be on the lookout if you have gotten any of those cards. And let me know what you think in the comments section down below, as now our cards are getting up there, as the 98 Brent Burns and Victor Hedman look nice. So guys, again, that is the content for Wednesday, and I will see you guys tomorrow.